Welcome to Thanks Academy, the podcast where we watch all the best picture winners, no matter what, in random order with random friends. And today's random friend slash victim is Andrew Horneman.
Hi.
Hi, Andrew. What are we going to watch today?
We're going to watch Ben-Hur.
We're going to watch Ben-Hur?
Ben-Hur.
Ben-Hur.
That would be a great transgender move. That's the transgender joke.
Yeah, let's get that joke out of the way. Let's
do that. You've already thought it. You know.
I don't want to know about it. Okay.
That's not what it's about, though.
What do you know about? Do you know anything about it?
There's two things I know. I know that it's a super log and that it could be about Jesus.
Oh, okay.
That's all I know.
All I know.
And that best picture of the year? Was it best picture of the year?
That's why we're watching it.
All the best pictures of the year, but not nominated.
Not nominated. You have to win to make this podcast.
Oh, because...
We don't take any losers.
Because there was a thing in... Steven Spielberg introduced a best picture of the year. So, like, if you're the winner of this category, you're in likes of Gone with the Wind and Schindler's List and all this.
Yeah.
But if you're lost... You're in the likes of Citizen Kane and Raging Bull. And he lists better movies.
I know. We're not... We're
not watching those movies.
We're not watching good movies. We're watching all the best picture winners of all time, which sometimes does not yield a very pleasant experience.
In fact, God.
More than half the time, this is not fun.
Did you watch Crash?
Not yet. It's coming. Okay, so here's what I know about Ben-Hur. It's 3 hours and 45 minutes long.
Oh, God damn it.
And there's a chariot race.
Oh. Mm. What?
You're That's not like the only thing I think it's famous for.
Oh, okay.
I don't know what it means. I don't know where there's when, why
there's a chariot race. I might have known. Nope, I didn't know about.
And I know it won the most Oscars ever.
Really?
Until something else came along and beat it. But it
held Titanic!
Probably Titanic. Yeah, I think even something's beat Titanic. I don't know. It was holding the record for a while.
Something beat Titanic.
Maybe that was box office. Maybe Titanic still has that record.
Okay. Am I talking deep to the mic?
You're doing a great job, Andrew.
Okay.
Do you have any, before we dive into this 3-hour and 45-minute
God
movie,
damn it.
Do you have any medical conditions that I should know about?
I probably will have to go to the or do the
bathroom breaks. Do you want to do a no pause or yes pause rule?
Let's do a yes pause.
Okay. I like to see every
scene.
I was
a cinephile person. Okay. I held hands with my ex at, like, what's it called? Ingmar Bergman films.
Oh. Okay. Well, no, that's fine. That's why I asked. I am totally willing to pause, even though it's going to drag this on.
I'm so sorry.
Even longer. That's okay.
Maybe not.
Now, I think I know the answer because of what you just said. What's your cinematic attention span like? Does like a long movie kill you, or are you?
No, if I'm deeply in, I'm in.
You're in? Okay. And what's your talking ratio? Do you like to talk?
Or
are you like a shut the fuck up and let me get into this space?
See, I was shut the fuck up, let me get into this space. Yeah. But now I'm more a social person.
Oh, what happened?
No, because I think I numbed myself into watching lots of movies because I was in Tucson, Arizona, so there was this art house called. Mm-hmm. The Loft, and I would just watch all these indie movies by myself, and that was it. Like, I watched Dallas Buyers Club in the theater when that came, so I'd watch all the Oscar movies, but everything that was just nominated.
Oh, yeah, okay.
And then it was Dallas Buyers Club before it had big release, so here I am in this art house film, and I'm the only one in the goddamn...
Right.
So it was like...
Just you.
500-seater.
Wow.
And me... That scene just explains like my but it was a beautiful movie. Beautiful goddamn movie.
Sure.
You didn't see it.
I saw it.
Okay, but you didn't like it.
I liked everything except for Jared Leto.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, I was very upset about that.
Oh.
Yeah, but I'm like that. I'm a person, see, this is as my regular listeners will know. I hate everything. Especially good movies. I just want to tear them down and tear them apart and find the reason why they're wrong and bad.
To make
myself feel better.
Ah, okay. But now I like watching stuff in the big audience and
I like how you just took that.
Yeah, no.
That makes perfect sense.
That makes exact sense. We're going to shit on Ben-Hur. Like, assholes are going to go up and wait, I can swear, right?
Sure. I don't think we're going to... I think we're going to have to swear to make it through this movie.
You shit on a lot of these movies. You don't like any of these movies that you've seen.
I've liked a couple. There have been a couple that I've really liked. I unexpectedly loved Chicago. I did not think I was going to like it.
What's so good?
It's really good.
Yeah.
I don't know why I was set up to not like it. I really liked You Can't Take It With You.
I didn't see that. I don't know.
Oh, that's a good... It's like a 1930s romantic comedy.
Oh, okay.
It's so good.
And it won best... Wow.
Yeah. It was a miracle.
Wow.
Like, they used to get it right, I think. They used to actually pick the best movies.
But then Ben-Hur.
I don't know. Maybe this is going to be one of those epics that's like, God, I'm glad I saw that. Really changed, like, my view of what cinema could be. Or maybe it'll just be 4 hours of Jesus. I don't know.
I have no goddamn idea.
I'm scared because you said that.
I don't know. I thought Mary Magdalene and Joseph were in Ben-Hur. I don't even know.
Seriously?
Who's Ben-Hur then?
I don't know. How does Ben-Hur get top billing if Jesus is sitting around? Why am I asking you?
I didn't even know the chariot race that ruined it.
Oh, I hope not. I mean, I thought that was the one thing everybody knew about Ben-Hur is it has a chariot race.
Hey, I watched Citizen Kane and had no idea what Rosebud meant.
Me neither.
Okay, good. Good.
I am so good at avoiding spoilers that I come across as extremely ignorant.
But
on
I don't.
The podcast.
I don't think that the chariot race is a spoiler. But like, I had no idea it was coming.
Yeah, the chariot race in this movie it like shows up on every Oscar telecast.
Nope.
Ever.
No idea.
If you see a chariot race,
no idea.
Okay. Well, you just are chariot
you ruined
blind.
It. You ruined. You ruined you ruined the experience.
No.
You ruined the middle.
Anyway.
You ruined the middle.
I don't know if it's even in the middle. Alright, you're gonna have this experience whether you like it or not. You ready?
Yeah, what if it's in the beginning?
Oh god, what have I done?
Okay, we're still on, right? Yeah, we're still.
Okay, there's an overture.
Okay, so we do talk in the middle of this, right?
Oh yeah, totally. You don't have to, but
okay. I get intense, but it's an overture, Jesus Christ.
Well, yeah. How long is this overture? I don't know, so I can, like...
No, like, let's talk over the overture.
I can't fast forward yet. That'd be, like, really giving up.
Yeah, nope.
Okay.
We'll live in it, but we don't have to... We could talk over it.
So far, I've seen two movies that are overtures, and they're both from this time period. West Side Story and Around the World in 80 Days. In fact, I think those were, like, back-to-back-to-back years.
Okay.
So there's a whole time period, it seems like, when they, like, did this shit.
Oh, yeah. Oh, what's it called? 2001 Space Odyssey.
Has an overture?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. I'm trying to think of others I've seen that have done this whole, like, oh, it's an opera thing.
But it only works in a movie with an audience. Only works with an audience. I saw it with Hateful Eight. There's overture had Eiffel, but it was in the 70mm, but it was all these people and they're eating popcorn. It makes sense in the theater.
Oh, I don't think that's in the, I only saw it at home, so
yeah.
I don't think that was in there
at
that point. It was only in the theater?
Yeah, but because it's a theatrical experience.
Yeah, you're like getting seated.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is bullshit.
Doing this. This is... Can't be annoyed yet. This is Michelangelo. We're looking at Sistine Chapel.
So this has nothing to do with Jesus.
So this is taking place in the Renaissance? I don't know. It's still going, though. We're still looking at the word overture, everybody.
It's still pretty. Yeah, but this is... Yeah.
It's an okay overture.
I used to respect the overture.
How did you respect it? Like, did you pray?
No, just get into the mood.
I like the little Middle Eastern flourishes they threw in there.
Yeah,
that's cool. Wait,
West Side Story won Best Picture.
Hell yeah, and it was good. That was one I liked.
Yeah,
it was really good.
The lyrics by Stephen Sondheim, music by Leonard Bernstein.
That's right. I thought you were gonna say music by Steven Spielberg, and I was gonna like
correct me.
I'd have to because that's silly.
Steven Spielberg. Wait, has he directed a musical?
Oh, boy, that's a good question. I want to say no, but, like, I'm sure he's done so much.
Why hasn't Steven Spielberg directed a musical?
Gosh. That's a good question. He's a very big, broad, like, full of emotions guy.
Yeah.
I can't even think of a movie where he's directed a musical sequence. You know? Like, random song and dance, like Spider-Man 3.
Yeah. Or the Shape of Water.
Yeah.
Didn't
see that.
Oh man, I ruined it.
Going to.
A
I ruined that middle for you.
I'm going to, right? Didn't it win?
It did win. Yeah,
okay. No, I haven't seen anything in the last 5 years.
Oh.
Well, except Marvel movies.
The Shape.
I keep wasting my money on those.
But you like it.
I do.
You love the shit.
I do. I love the shit.
You hate pretentious art or pretentious Oscar movie.
I hate everything.
Oh, God.
This overture is over.
I was mad. I was mad in 2005 when Crash won Best Picture.
Well, I mean, that's, the most notorious disaster of a pick of all time, isn't it?
Because Brokeback Mountain should have won that year.
I totally agree. I just watched Shakespeare in Love. That was another terrible pick. That was an awful movie.
It was okay.
It was up against Saving Private Ryan, Life is Beautiful, Elizabeth, and Thin Red Line. And you're right, it was an okay movie. How the hell did it win?
Oh yeah, but that's why Steven Spielberg was like, look, if you're in this class, you're going to win.
Oh, because he's got a lot of movies on that list.
Yeah, because if you're in the winner, you're going to be in this list. But if you're in the loser, you're with Citizen Kane, Saving Private Ryan, Raging Bull, you're in these better movies. A Clockwork Orange.
Well, this movie will be not that long if...
I think the overture's an hour.
Does it let me scan visually?
No, let's just do it. Live it. Let's live into this.
No, I don't want to miss the very first shot of this movie.
I know, so let's live it. Okay, we're going to talk over the overture.
We're living in it.
Or do we listen to the music? Do you like to listen?
Yeah, let's listen to the music while I look up where our food is.
Okay.
Sorry, I'm blocking your view of the overture. So have you learned the tune yet? Can you hum it? That was more like a high-pitched mosquito whine.
Did it win? Did it win Best Score? It won
11 Oscars in a year, back in the times when there were 12 of them. So I'm sure it won everything. Yeah.
Except for the music.
Let me look it up.
Probably won Best Music. Yeah, look it up.
All right. I got nothing else to do. I don't have to look at the screen right now.
We're so ADD right now.
Oh, that's what I was afraid of. That both of our ADDs would take over and we wouldn't make it.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Ben. I don't want to see any spoilers, though.
Come on, that's a... Oh, yeah.
Meow, 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 meow. I'll look up 1959 Oscars. So this is 1959. I was right. This is the same. It's right before.
What was nominated this year?
That's what I'm going to look up right now. It was right before West Side Story and right after Around the World in 80 Days, which sucked.
Wow. But West Side Story, you loved.
West Side Story was great. I like musicals.
Ooh.
Oh, it's fading out.
Yep. There we go.
We made it.
Yay.
Another overture! Yay! Was that Jesus, Mom and Dad?
I don't know. Maybe.
He said David, though, not Joseph. Yeah. Are they proposing that Mary was fooling around?
How do you think she got pregnant?
Exactly. Maybe this movie's bold.
I don't think so.
It's like the Da Vinci Code prequel.
Or the
Sorry, spoiler alert for Da Vinci Code.
The Temptation of Christ.
Mm-hmm. Oh, look, an airplane.
We're not going to enjoy this, are we? We're not going to enjoy the movie for what it is.
Are we supposed to?
Maybe.
There's the three wise men. Boy, all the famous people. There they are.
Oh.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Right?
That's... No, those will get burst in flames.
Oh. I thought they had names, though. Didn't they have names, the three wise men?
Yeah.
Oh, this is Andrew and Karina trying to remember their churchin. Did you get churchin?
Churchin?
Yeah, did you grow up in a church?
Yeah, Catholic.
Oh, me too. High five. No wonder we don't remember.
Okay, yeah. But, no, I want to try to absorb this movie, but okay.
Are you telling me to shut up?
But, do we talk?
Yeah.
Should we talk in front of...
Let's listen.
Okay.
Ben-Hur!
Jesus! The Tale of the Christ by General Lew Wallace.
Wow.
Well, this is another goddamn overture.
Yeah, it is. It's the opening credits. We're 12 minutes in, and we got to Charlton Heston. Hell yeah, I hope he plays God.
Okay.
He probably plays Ben-Hur, I'm guessing.
Yeah. Who's Ben-Hur? So this is about Jesus.
That's definitely about Jesus. There's Jesus. Walking around. Are we ever going to see his face?
26, that's my favorite year. It's a good age.
Were you walking around in the woods a lot in 26?
I was working on wood. JK, no, I was not. I was not working. Well, no, wait. Actually, yeah, I was. I was working a lot of wood.
Okay. Don't say JK.
I want to get into this.
I'm already tired of trumpets.
This is too much procession.
It's too much brass. You like two men giggling at each other?
And they're crying.
Hmm.
Oh, there's a... This movie's filled with homoerotic subtext. I forgot about this.
They're besties. Wow, wedding toast style.
What the hell?
No kiss. Oh, even better, show us the sticks touching. Wow.
Oh my god. Oh.
Oh
man.
Look
at almost cry.
Ooh. But think about the makeup sex they're gonna have.
God damn it. Who's top?
I don't think it's ever the Roman, right?
Oh, she's on top.
Mm-hmm. Where's the saga?
Oh yeah, because he gave him the horse.
Where's the saga?
Tops give presents,
right?
That's why.
Oh, wait, you said you weren't gonna do... Okay.
What? Ugh. But...
Yeah, she's clearly into it, dude. Go ahead. Wow.
Is she?
No.
But neither is he.
Or, that was her...
I really want the gay subtext so bad.
I think it's there, but I also think that this is the slave master... forcing his tongue down the throat of his recently freed slave.
Yeah. Should have kissed her before he took the ring.
No. That's what he's thinking now.
Well, that was a rape joke, right? That was
close enough.
Rapey, yeah. That was, yeah,
Hey, rock concert. Hey, Jesus is the one person who's taller than him. See? Hey.
Oh, look at his eyes!
Oh, wow.
Look!
He's like, wow.
Charlton Heston is gorgeous as fuck. Charlton Heston is,
Hey, I'll see you around.
I like seeing him smile and being on his knees getting water from Christ.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Oh, he's smitten.
Yeah, he's got a reason to live now. Deus ex Christus, I guess.
Oh man.
Ugh. Oh yeah, he's gonna have some upper body strength now.
Oh yeah. Oh wow, what the hell? Okay, this is the gayest scene. fun.
Coming alongside, ready to raise them.
Because they're doing a spin class together.
Shit.
A couple of leather daddies making sure that they do their job.
Give them water first.
Yeah. Everybody's like, okay, we better look at each other.
Are you sure. What are you doing?
Leave me alone.
You texting?
No.
Facebook?
I'm just doing something.
It's okay.
I'm back.
That's a good sound bite.
You on your phone? We're not even at intermission. There's going to be an intermission.
Oh, there's going to be an intermission, isn't there?
Yeah, there is. Oh. Don't send it back, you son of a bitch.
Yeah.
He won't. He's not going to. Oh.
He's back, baby.
But you know what the intermission's going to be.
Oh, you think they're going to do the chariot race before the intermission?
No.
What?
I hope. I hope he means.
I don't know. Okay.
Okay, I'm not going to tell you what I think it is, but I think I know what it is.
Ooh, you got a nice fancy outfit.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. Look at the feathers. Ooh, but him, Ben looks good.
Wait, that's not Jerusalem. Are they in Rome? They're in Rome.
Yeah.
Because the people are happy to see him.
The textures are ridiculous. Look at this.
I know, seriously. Damn.
CGI and stuff like this.
Yeah. Jeez.
Okay, this is pretty epic.
All right, I like Caesar a lot.
Yeah, this is great.
He's like got a, I don't know, television hostness about him.
Yeah.
Like he's hosting a kid show.
I know. This has actually got good.
Yeah, I'm into this movie. I really am. I just didn't want to hear any more of that rowing music.
No. It's epic as fuck.
Oh, it's a bed.
He's gonna go back to
Yeah, he's going back.
Oh shit.
Here he goes. He even put on his little Jerusalem outfit.
Oh. I can't.
Ooh.
He's gonna see Christ again. Only and his boyfriend.
Just the back of his head.
And his ex.
He's gonna see his ex.
I hope to God he does.
Oh, who's that?
His father.
No? No, who is that?
Well, that's his dad. That's his daddy.
That's his real daddy?
His other daddy, yeah.
Oh man, this guy has so many daddies.
I mean, look at him.
Santa daddy.
I don't blame him for having another dad, for having like five fathers.
Oh, sure. It's convenient.
Oh.
I do like all these like giant water spoons. They seem smart.
And water on his face.
Alright, we got.
And his slave ring.
Slave girlfriend ring.
And then what about this daddy ring?
Yeah. Wow, he's going full BDSM. He's got a slave ring on one hand and a daddy ring on the other.
I want a daddy ring.
Hey.
That's his father.
Remember me?
Dad! Wake up, son.
Got another daddy ring for you.
Forgive me.
Best director, best actor. Yep, Charlton Heston.
Really? Okay, they did give it to him.
Best supporting actor was that guy that we just saw the
what, the white man?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Hugh Griffith. Of course he's white.
Oh. Oh! The one that was doing the...
The Arabian guy. He was just...
Oh,
yeah.
So he has a better part.
I guess. Well,
he just entered...
Or they just really liked the shit with the horses.
Or his face.
Oh, wow. Nobody bought his house?
Oh.
I mean, you figure that'd be like a steal on the market, you know?
Oh my god. There wasn't a real estate agent.
I don't believe it. That was a big house. Oh, look, nobody's collected his mail.
And father figures all over the place.
Seriously? He's got so many daddies.
Ben Daddy.
Ben Gay.
Ben Gay.
We stood here before.
There it is.
Yep.
There's the best joke. Ben Gay.
Do we? I feel like we're making good progress.
Boy, when I said I accidentally touched this.
Oh no. Oh no, don't tell me.
I'm not going to.
Let me just ask this. Is there still going to be an intermission?
Probably.
Oh god.
I think so. I could be wrong.
Well, I guess Jesus isn't going to cure them then.
No, he will.
How do you know?
I don't know. I have faith.
Oh, God. He just remembered he has to do some revenging now.
Oh, first boy.
Maybe he should have kept that sweet knife.
He should have got his axe.
Intermission! Yes! Okay, go to the bathroom. I'm not gonna pause the intermission though. No. Oh, good timing.
Yeah, I heard the music.
Yeah.
I've watched enough musical theater to know when the interact is coming.
I was going to blink the lights for you.
Yep.
There you go. Let's jump right back into it with some, wow, some good old chest massage.
Oh, I love a front massage.
Oh, yeah. Oh, look, it's boyfriend, too. You like that?
Flexed a little bit.
You like how to... How they like to sign stuff back then with their fists?
No, but then his chest...
I saw it too!
Oh.
Wow, this is,
this is so...
I did not expect this to be a sports movie.
No. Or gay as fuck.
Oh, that part's just been delightful. A delightful surprise. Yeah. Oh,
Jesus.
Oh my god. Whoa.
Ooh, Jesus.
That was brutal.
Jesus.
He just ran over a dude.
Yeah.
How many fish have they gone?
Not enough.
Oh, yeah, you don't need a stretcher for him yet. That guy.
Oh, I thought I'd beat a dead horse.
Yeah. That guy's a speed bump.
Come listen. Like, they're talking about like it's a, like the showtime.
Yeah.
Did he wait until all 5,000 showed up?
Yep.
Was it 5,000?
Sure. He kind of waited, you know. Comedy show rules. You let a few stragglers come
in. So this is the 5 o'clock or 7 o'clock?
This is 5 o'clock. 7 o'clock is when he ran out of fish.
This is the early show.
And he started with just 2 drink tickets, but somehow there were enough drink tickets for everybody.
Oh god.
Oh, we get more back of the head, Jesus.
Yeah, but...
Why are they being so... weird about Jesus' face? hear anybody, like, right?
I think he did.
But, like...
There's a bunch of shit that happens here. Strata Turin, right?
Oh, yeah.
He wipes his face.
We'll find out.
Yeah. Stay tuned. Oh, check it out. Historically accurate crosses.
What do you mean?
The headpiece isn't on yet.
Oh man, I'm... Boy, I'm nodding off.
We're almost there, buddy.
Okay.
We just gotta get these lepers cured and I think it's over. This movie is slow!
As fuck.
See?
I'm like passing out.
No, wake up!
Oh. Wait. Oh,
they're better!
Just by.
They just needed a rainstorm.
But Jesus is in that rock?
He's in the lightning. He's in the air right now.
He's in.
Oh, he's everywhere, he's infecting them. Almost there. 3 minutes.
Then Ben-Hur.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Oh, she didn't tell him. Surprise! Happy birthday.
Yeah. Oh my god. And they did take. I guess they did see the late show.
Yeah. The really late show. He did like the open mic after the show.
Like strong closer.
Yeah. Oh,
God.
Yeah. That's how you know the end is coming, when the choir kicks in.
Damn it.
Oh, ew. Whoa, dude. That's your sister.
I thought you like.
Yeah.
Laid one on her. But,
oh, yeah, he gets all the ladies.
But he's not married. But he didn't marry the like, woman, did he?
Nah.
He could still be Ben gay. Ben gay.
Yeah, he's still a bachelor.
Oh, God.
Hallelujah. The end.
Actually, like... Oh, that wasn't that bad.
It literally put you to sleep. I had to wake you up in the last 20 minutes. Two times.
It was too much. Okay, at the end it was too much.
It was way... This is the slowest movie. I mean, it's good.
It will.
Good things happen in it, but they all happen slowly.
And but the gay subtext.
You were so delicious.
This, oh my god, Ben-Hur and what's his name?
Boyfriend.
That's all boyfriend. We can call him. It's so.
All right.
And the charity race was.
The charity race.
The charity race. The charity race. It was preachy at the end. Too preachy at the end.
Yeah. For those who haven't seen it, Ben-Hur's like a rich guy. And he's a Jew. And the Romans are there. And this is all Jesus times. And he's friends like with... He's old school friends with one of the Romans who comes back to be like...
Oh, yeah. You have to explain.
The governor. Plot. Yeah.
This is so, a long like, plot. I'm...
It's like his best... No, this, we'll get through this fast. This is easy.
Okay.
So, his best friend... comes back and they're like totally in love.
Yes, the best. What's his name?
Mussolini.
We're just.
We're just go with Mussolini.
Mussolini? No, Mussolini.
Marcellus.
Marcellus. Marcellus.
Is it Marcellus?
I think it's Marcellus.
All right, I'll buy it.
I think it's Marcellus. So Marcellus.
Yeah.
And
Ben-Hur, they're in love.
Well, Ben-Hur, but it's. Judah
Ben-Hur.
Judah Ben-Hur.
Ben is his Bend over, Ben Gay, whatever.
Ben here.
They love each other so much.
So much. It's
one of the most intense, most well-acted homosexual love scenes I think I've ever seen.
They love each other.
When they first see each other.
But then Marcellus is like, hey, Judah, I want you to just turn in one of your Jews.
That's the problem, is that his old boyfriend became a cop.
Okay, so, okay. Yeah.
And it was like asking him to snitch.
And then he was like, no. And then he's like, fuck you. But, like, we're still friends, right? And he's like, yeah, fine.
Yeah.
And then what happened is that there's this whole procession, and that they were on a roof, accidentally, like, pushed a rock over, or his sister pushed the rock over.
Yeah.
And it injured one of the governors, and he's like, I didn't do...
Yeah, all sentenced to death.
Yeah. And then he's like, I didn't do it. And then Marcellus is like, you did. I know you didn't do it, but, like, you're going to get killed because you know...
Yeah, Marcellus is like, you didn't do it, but, like, I'm a cop, and I'm trying to be, like, going up in the ranks.
Yes.
So I got to throw you down because you won't snitch. Yeah. So it's The Wire.
Oh, and I didn't see The Wire.
Well, I don't have any either, but whatever.
Is that what The Wire is about?
Season 8 of The Wire. I don't know what the fuck The Wire is about. Okay, so then... so the girls, the mom and the sister go into the dungeon. And Judah gets sent on a ship.
Yes.
Cut to 3 years later. Judah's been working out in the belly of a ship.
Oh, yeah. He's a slave in the belly. Yeah. And they're just doing fucking rows.
For fucking years. For 3 years.
So fucking... Okay, Charlton Heston. So fucking gorgeous. So fucking gorgeous.
Andrew wouldn't shut up the whole movie about how hot Charlton Heston was. And I don't disagree.
He's going to be in my spank bank tonight.
He's a monster.
In my spank bank.
Person, but sure, if you young want to, he's Charlton dead, Heston, you can jerk off to him now, I
young
guess.
Young Charlton Heston, Academy Award winner, Charlton Heston, is going to go in my spank bank. Ben-Hur.
To be fair, he barely wears clothes in this movie. Yeah.
Barely Ben.
Barely
Ben. Barely wearing anything.
Bareback her.
There we go. How many? That's an editing nightmare for you, but you have to do now.
Okay. Anyway. It's okay. You can nut on this podcast. What? So, nothing.
You can nut.
I said nut. It's fine. Okay, whatever. He gets off the galley because he saves the ship captain.
Oh, yeah. He shares... Yeah, the captain.
He saves his life, and the captain happens to be, like, the vice president of Rome.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so, like, he goes to meet Caesar, which is cool. Caesar was awesome.
Yeah.
I think it was technically Tiberius, but whoever. Tiberius, Caesar. They're all Caesars.
And then, so... Okay. And then he adopts him.
Yeah.
Then he becomes a race guy.
That's, like, his second daddy.
Yes.
Oh, there's so many daddies. Wait.
God damn it. Then was that the whole... Do we have to say the whole Jesus thing in the...
Oh, yeah. Jesus was around. Okay, so the movie opens with the birth of Jesus. Before we even get to the credits. And then while Charlton Heston's getting frog marched down to the galleys...
Yeah.
Jesus gives him a cup of water.
Yes, and it's a big thing. Oh, Charlton Heston looks so gorgeous as this water just on his goddamn face. Just like...
Yeah.
Oh, it's like semen on top of his face. Like, just like a... Like, a, like, like just... Oh, take it, Jesus. Give it to me, Jesus Christ.
So Andrew was praying during that part of the film in his own way.
Like, he was just like, oh, like, just like taking it
in. And it helps that we never see Jesus' face the whole movie, because Jesus can be whoever you want. Talk about a spank bank.
Oh, yeah, I'm still...
You can see the back of his... Yeah, I know, you want Charlton Heston, that's fine. The back of Jesus' head looks a lot like, I don't know, Jennifer Connelly in A Beautiful Mind. So, like, I get got like a nice chestnut curl going on. Shoulder length, nothing too long. Man. Yeah, it's good. Okay, so what? Oh, so he saves, he becomes vice president of Rome's son.
Oh, yes.
And while he's doing that, he learns how to drive a race car.
Yes.
Yeah. And so he gets sent back. He decides he's now that he's free and he's important. He can go back to Jerusalem.
Yes.
To kill Marcellus Wallace. Yes.
Marcellus Wallace. Who's Marcellus Wallace?
Oh, what? I just looked up his name. His name's like Marcelli or something.
Marcelli, not Marcellus.
Marcelli?
Marcelli.
It's his terrible name. Masala.
Marsala. That's so hard.
It's a stupid name.
Did he win the Academy Award?
He didn't win shit.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. So on the way back to...
He should. For
being hot?
For best wax. For best shiny chest.
Oh, yeah. He does have a shiny chest. Not a very buff one, but boy, does it oil up well.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
He looked like he was dipped in gelatin in that one scene. There's a scene with a massage parlor that I think is Andrew can't handle right now.
So much. Okay.
So in Jerusalem, Charlton Heston does meet the other actor who did win an Academy Award, and that was some British guy wearing blackface to look Arab.
Oh, yes.
The Sheik.
So he meets the Sheik,
uh-huh.
And then they fart, or they burp.
They fart and burp together.
And then they're like, hey, you're going to race the horse, my white horse, against the other guy's black horses.
Yeah, I mean, it got weirdly like...
Oh, yeah. We have to say the entertainment part.
No. So anyway, the best supporting actor of 1959 is totally in just bronzy blackface the whole time. It's totally embarrassing. But he is his new sponsor. He's Judah's new sponsor for his race car.
Oh, yeah. Oh, race car. That's good. Good job. Yeah.
He hands him his 4-horsepower race car.
4-horsepower. Jeez.
Then there's finally an intermission.
Oh, yeah.
And when Judah gets back to Jerusalem, he finds out that, he had this slave. Wow. How do we skip over this?
No.
When he was growing up, his family had like tons of slaves because they were like rich.
Oh yeah, but what
and
about...
one of them was a hot girl who he decided to free so that he could marry her, but she was already marrying someone else.
Oh yeah, then he had the ring, and then then he comes back to his house.
Yeah,
but then when he comes back to see his boyfriend, what about that scene? Yes. Jesus Christ, Jesus!
And his boyfriend's hanging out with some guy who looks like his name is Todd.
Oh, yeah. And he's just whooping. He's just out there.
He's just like, look, Todd, look at me whipping some shit. And then, like, Judah shows up and he stops whipping right then. Then he pulls out his knife and is like,
well, no, it's a present. Here's a present.
Judah gave him a knife and he was like, I'm going to touch it while I talk to you.
But what happened? Somebody introduced the present and is like, this is very extravagant.
Because it was coming from the vice president of Rome.
Yeah. He's like, who's the vice president? And then Judah comes
in. Judah's like, my daddy.
And then I'm the vice president. And then he has the ring thing. And he's like, you know the symbol. And then...
Yes. He has like the vice president's seal on his ring. So he like...
And then...
pounds it into some paper. And is like, what's up with that? And then Masala was like, this is hot. But Todd's here.
So hot. Oh, God.
Yeah, that scene was incredible.
And then he's like, what do you want me to do with this knife? I'm going to stab myself with it. I'm going to stab myself. My mom and my sister.
Yeah, Judah's like, business before pleasure, baby. And then, like, he tries to... His mom and sister are still in the dungeon. Still, 4 years later. Probably dead. Whatever.
Yeah, he doesn't know. And then he's like, search them.
Anyway, he goes back home. His home turned into a rainforest cafe.
After the robots die,
yeah. He's in the post-robot apocalypse, Terminator 5
Does Rainforest Cafe still exist?
It probably does, but it probably looks like that. Like, it's just been abandoned in a mall for 4 years. All the plastic vines have gotten out of control. And that's where he runs into his old slave, and she's still free and single, so they hook up.
Yeah, but then he doesn't...
Not really.
Yeah,
I mean, he kisses her because he's supposed to.
Yeah, but there's more tension between him and Marcella.
10 times more.
So much more. Okay, then...
I like Marcella. That's nice.
Is it Marcella?
It's Masala.
Marcella.
Okay, so...
So he died, so...
Wait. Oh, no, okay. Well, then he said before he left, he was like, to Masala, he was like, hey, find my family or I'll kill you.
Yeah.
And Masala took that seriously, so he went and found a family. Guess what? They were still alive.
Oh, but they have leprosy.
They're lepers. They're stone-cold lepers now. So they go to the leper colony, and slave girl decides to keep their secret because they're embarrassed or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
So now Judah thinks his family's dead and he's out for vengeance.
Yes.
And that sets up the race. The race car race.
Oh, yeah, the race. Okay.
The big chariot race.
That's the big one. That's the big Academy Award.
Yep. And they run in circles and people die and get trampled and it's great.
Oh, yeah, then his boyfriend's really mean.
His boyfriend's a cheater. He pimped out his ride. With some, like, steel rims.
How do you say
rims.
His name?
Masala.
He has a fucking whip.
Yeah, he's got a strong whip. Remember he was whipping that shit?
Also, like, the chariot race looks like it's so fucking epic. Like, it's like the
it's great.
It's really epic. It's like all these people.
It takes like half an hour. It's awesome.
And then whipping the black horses. That's the black horses with the little
right before the race, blackface friend puts a Star of David on Charlton Heston and be like, you know, we Jews and Arabs got to stick together, and that was interesting.
He did say
that. Well, this is before the whole Islam thing was invented, so they were like, okay, back then. I don't know how things were. I'm trusting this obviously super duper Christian movie to tell me about Jews and Arabs.
Well,
I'm
because
not really
the more Jewy person is like tall.
It is a 6 foot tall blonde blue eyed Jew.
Yes.
That's worth pointing out.
God bless him.
I think that's what they were trying to say. I think that's what the message was. Anyway, just like this, you know, this movie like had so many parallels to Star Wars. Swear to God, George Lucas saw Ben-Hur a ton.
Well, but
because that was exactly like the pod race.
But it's like the you're right.
The chariot race and the pod race are like
seemed just as epic. Like the chariot race was pretty epic. It still holds up.
I didn't say the pod race was better. The chariot race is better than the pod race. But like it felt like the same moves.
But the chariot race was so epic. That was actually. Then he got trampled.
It was bloody. It was.
Yeah, the Mars. Okay, so.
Yeah.
It's really brutal. We know
Masala gets trampled.
And then, because he whipped him. He whipped Ben.
He whipped Ben.
I just called him Ben the whole entire time.
He whipped his fuck buddy. And.
Did they really have. I don't think they had sex.
I think they did back in the day before he became a cop. I mean, they were throwing spears together.
God, the sexual tension between the two. They loved each other.
Hell yeah.
They still did love each other.
They still did right to the end. Because he wouldn't let anybody get his legs chopped off because he wanted to see him intact.
And then grabbed him before he died as it was all bloody and...
Oh, yeah.
And then Charlton Heston's crying.
Oh, yeah.
After he found... But
he's
I mean,
so emo, he skips out on Jesus' Sermon on the Mount. Yes. That's how emo he is for his dead boyfriend.
Oh, yeah. Then they treated the Sermon on the Mount like it was a showtime. Like, you gotta go listen to this guy. Listen to this guy. Everybody's coming up. I'm surprised they didn't have tickets to the...
Yeah, it was like a TED Talk was about to happen. But Charlton Heston's like, no, I'm too sad about my boyfriend. I'm going to go. And then he goes and talks to Pontius Pilate, who's governor now. And I guess he was offered citizenship in Rome, but he was like, no, snitches still get stitches. I am not joining the Romans. Yeah. I just let my boyfriend go.
And he won the chariot race, but it didn't matter.
It didn't matter.
He got that crown, but then he left the crown, watched his boyfriend die.
Nah, he was true to the Jew all the way. Like, he was not going to turn.
Then the Jesus shit took too much. It's too much.
So we have to watch the whole Passion. We have to watch the trial.
Yeah, but they treated it like the prequel, like a sequel that we were like a prequel. Ben-Hur was like the prequel to Jesus.
Yeah. Anyway, Jesus walks by, and he's dragging his cross, and Ben-Hur tries to give him some water, like to you know.
It didn't work.
Didn't work, but it was like a nice gesture.
And then, but he did. There was a moment where he did look at Christ.
They saw each. They made eye contact. They were like, "What's up?" I remember when we did this.
I remember. Yeah.
Yeah. Then he finally remembers who Jesus is. Anyway, then Jesus gets crucified. You may have heard this story, and then there's a lightning storm.
Yeah.
And in the lightning storm, all the leprosy goes away.
Yes. And then...
Somehow.
And then Ben, I don't know what Ben's doing. Ben-Hur
just goes home and he sees his like chick and he tells her, "I don't want to kill people anymore." And she's like, "You are Jesus' person."
Oh, because I heard Jesus cry at the cross.
He's no longer consumed with vengeance, and she's loving him again because she didn't want vengeance.
And then he sees his wife.
Sees his sister and his mom, and they're cool now. So that means he's not going to get leprosy. Yeah, so that's good.
And then sister, mom, and sort sister, of mom, wife,
and like.
Maybe wife.
All his bitches were there, and
but then all of his father figures are gone.
All the daddies are gone.
Even Christ.
That's right. Jesus is gone. His boyfriend is gone.
His father is gone.
And he renounced his vice president father. So he got rid of all his daddies. Dang it. So it's a sad ending.
Yeah.
It's a tragedy.
It was an epic. It was an epic. Actually, like,
I think I've got the tagline, sort of. Okay, Ben-Hur is the tragic story of a gay man who ends up being straight because they killed Jesus.
Maybe. Yeah.
That's my thing. That's what I'm sticking to.
All the men in his life got punished, and now he's he's with three needy women.
He was denied. Now he's with three needy women.
Yeah, because who's going to pay the bills?
Right? Well, I guess he's a pretty good chariot racer.
Oh, yeah.
So.
Oh, yeah, he's pretty rich.
Yeah, he could probably do okay.
Huh.
Yeah.
I think that's
the movie.
But.
Do you have, okay, now some thoughts.
A lot more.
We're exhausted.
So tiring, but like, I'm glad I watched.
So slow.
Yeah. Glad I watched it.
Yeah, why?
I was avoiding this movie.
Me too.
Like,
the
I did
only
not
reason we went to this movie, can I tell, is because Andrew has seen so many movies.
I have so many.
The first three we drew, you've already seen. And so I just had to keep going until I found one you didn't see. And it was this, and I didn't want to do it because it's so long and seemed so dumb.
It seemed awful.
But it ended up being the perfect movie.
So
for the
perfect.
Two of us to watch.
Oh, yeah. And we ate Thai food.
Watching a black-faced guy
but
and a blue-eyed Jew while we eat Chinese food.
So gay, but it was so gay.
Everything about this night was too gay.
It was so gay. It was the gayest.
I don't think we're probably not the first people to notice this.
I'm guessing
it's too obvious. This isn't just like, oh, listen to the queer podcast where they're noticing queer things in movies where it's not really there. Seriously, Ben Gay. This is so gay.
You gotta find all the puns that were in.
There are times when they say lines that it's just like I expected like someone to come out from the side and go, "Hello," you know.
They kind of Pontius Pilate was like,
Pontius Pilate literally started the race the way that RuPaul starts a season. I mean,
But they were so rough. Both of them were rough at each other.
Oh, yeah. No, it was a gay male movie. There was nothing for me in this movie.
Oh, yeah.
Except for the back of Jesus' head.
Yeah, there was... Ugh.
Yeah, there was not a lot for me to go on there. But that's okay. I'm glad you were rock hard half this movie for Charlton Heston. You
so
could not help it.
So much. Charlton Heston was so gorgeous.
I was the minute I saw his name, I was like, oh, geez, I don't like that person as a person.
He's so good.
But you know what? He's the best part of the movie.
He's the
awesome.
Only part of the movie.
He's the best so part. Good looking and so interesting, and he does deserve his little Oscar for it.
I didn't know he won an Oscar.
He won an Oscar. Along with the chic.
For some reason, I think he's more remembered for Planet of the Apes and Soylent Green.
Yeah, well, that's his later work. And and the Ten Commandments, which came before this. And
wow.
It's another biblical epic.
But did he win the Academy Award for that?
I don't think that won any Academy Awards. It's not a good movie. It may have won like best long ass movie that'll be played on Easter from now on.
But... So is that your podcast before you did this one?
No, my parents made me watch the Ten Commandments every Easter, so I've seen that movie.
Oh, I watch Jesus of Nazareth every Easter.
Huh.
Cause that's what you should watch.
I don't know. CBS was playing, or ABC or whoever was playing Ten Commandments every year with commercials.
Ew.
So I had to watch it with commercials.
We watched the VHS version of Jesus of Nazareth, and that's just as long.
Yeah, that's
weird. That's all Jesus stuff. That's all Jesus stuff.
No, I figured I think we knew our Jesus stuff. We needed some Old Testament learning.
This was good. I like that. I'm glad I watched this movie with you.
Yeah, this was, it was a lot of work. I mean, it was a lot of work.
You were on your cell phone at one
time. I did. That intermission came way too late. It scared me because I think of an intermission as halfway through. This one's 2/3 or even more. There's only an hour left when it comes.
Yeah, but that race, though.
That race is good.
Okay, well, I guess.
Hey, you guys, we're not telling you not to see the movie, and we're not telling you to see the movie. I mean, like, if you feel like 4 hours of softcore gay porn, this is probably the best you're going to get.
Yeah, and watch it with a friend and eat Thai food.
The end. I love it. Andrew, do you have anything you want to plug?
Oh, yeah, there's this Over the Rainbow at Alamo Drafthouse Mueller every Friday at 8 o'clock.
There you go.
Hopefully it's still lasting.
I'm sure it will. I'm going to be on it in a week. That'll keep it alive.
You're there tomorrow.
Oh, yeah. I'll be there. I'll be there a week and a half from yesterday. Whenever you hear this.
Oh, yeah. Really? You?
I don't know when I'm going to put it. It's a 4-hour episode to cut up.
I know. Good luck editing this.
Anyway, every Friday at 8 for free at the Barrel of Fun inside Alamo Drafthouse Mueller. And I can do this for you.
You're so precious.
Andrew co-hosts with just as much tongue-tiedness this wonderful...
The very
theoretically queer comedy showcase that usually has like a queer on it. And
I'm the queer.
You're the queer. Well, yeah. Sometimes there's an extra one for
queer. Colton's there. Yeah.
I'm there sometimes.
You're there sometimes.
Other people
are there sometimes. It's a great goddamn show.
It is. It's some of the best people in Austin do it. So there.
Yes.
Did that help?
Come. Yes.
Come.
Come there at 8 o'clock, Barrel of Fun, on every Friday, Alamo Draft House, yes. Your location.
Andrew's been watching Naked Charlton Heston for 4 hours, and he wants you to come.
Oh, so much.
That's enough of that. Please rate our podcast. Don't play it for your children.
Okay.
See you next week. Bye.